Now to a building in Dubai that is really capturing the world's imagination, and it has an Australian connection.
It's the world's tallest building, the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, and last night it lit up the skyline with a grand opening. Standing at 828 metres, the Burj towers over its nearest rival, Taiwan's Taipei 101, which reaches a mere 508 metres. It's more than twice the height of New York's Empire State Building and 2.5 times higher than Australia's tallest building, Eureka Tower. With 160 stories and 120,000 square metres of glass, it's the window cleaner's Mount Everest, and an Australian company has won the highly contested cleaning contract.
Dale Harding, the general manager of CoxGomyl, joins us now. Now, Dale, you design the equipment that cleans the tallest building in the world. How do you clean all those windows?
We actually had a total of 12 machines installed on the building at various levels, plus some smaller systems up the top. And the machines come out of the building at various levels and lower people down the side of the building to access the windows and replace panels that are defective.
It looks utterly terrifying by the pictures. Can I ask how long it takes to clean the building itself?
We anticipate around 3 months to do a full cycle. So we're looking at 4 cycles in total per year. That's the plan at this stage.
Does that mean then that they're literally just constantly cleaning the windows on this building?
Yeah, that's right. The upper levels are not quite the case, but certainly from level 40 and level 73 down, they're continually cleaning and all the machines are working around the clock for the entire duration.
Sounds like painting the Sydney Harbour Bridge, Dale. Now, if you can design these machines that go around the building, which is a really impressive piece of design, why is it you can't make it so that people aren't needed? I mean, you still need people up there with squeegees and soap suds and all of this. Why couldn't you just totally automate it?
Oh, there are a few organisations which have tried, but most of the projects we get involved with are more complex, with facade systems that are quite tricky. There's projections on the facade which make a normal automated system not a really a feasible option. We also find that the people do a better job usually than the machine.
Now, mate, I'm intrigued by window cleaning companies. Now, there's so many windows. There must be a lot of shenanigans going on inside those windows. Is there a code of conduct that you're not allowed to report what you see inside those windows?
Nothing official, but a lot of the facility managers in the big buildings do ask us to let them know which areas of the building we're going to be cleaning on given days so that they can warn the tenants.
I'm
there's
sure.
A few interesting stories, but...
How amazing.
I know,
look at that, how high up it is.
God, they need danger money for that. Oh. Dale, do you actually need oxygen when you're working up that high?
No. I think the highest part of the building is around 2,500 feet, so it's well short of that. But our guys do carry hydration packs on their back, which is similar to some motorcycle or some cyclist would wear to keep hydrated and prevent themselves from having problems
what,
with
what if they have to go to the toilet? Is it okay to wee from up there? Or?
It requires a bit of forward planning. Once they head out of the building, it usually takes they're there for most of the day. So I haven't actually heard how they deal with it exactly, but don't really want to know either.
Fascinating stuff, Dale. Thank you very much for joining us, and well done on designing the contraption. Now, there is some massive news.